share a room with him, against him also. And now here, we're just sharing some stories, which is not for public consumption. But I'll ask you why you're here, though. But before that, Sachin, is the family getting a bit tired of you being around all the time now?
Do they have any choice? earlier, who's getting in?
Because, you know, you've been traveling ever since you were 13, packing a bag, traveling, training. You know, it must be odd just being at home at times.
No, life's been busy, and I'm enjoying it. Every little thing that I'm involved in and being part of gives me a lot of satisfaction, just like on the field. I think off the field is the second innings. And as I always said that, you know, I'll continue to bat for India. And that's something gives me a lot of satisfaction.
Well, that's perfect. Yeah. But I know you've been a techie, and I remember still the day, maybe you don't remember, him and me walking down Oxford Street in about 89, just walking into the HMV stores and buying about 50 CDs, which we didn't have money to pay for. But we still bought them, Mark Knopfler, Dire Straits, you know, and I still got those CDs. And he's always been into, you know, gadgets and toys. But do you think technology has actually changed your life?
See, I'm glad that you took me back to those days in 1990. In fact, when I started my career in 1989, the team meetings were that, chalo, let's make a circle and we discuss strategies. And the coach and the captain and few senior players would talk about various things, you know, how they're going to bowl and how we should bat and all those kind of things. And then it was left up to each player's imagination ki outswinger kaise aa raha hai, inswing aise ho sakta hai, leg spin ya googly, whatever. But it was all about, you know, that how that individual imagined. Down the line, in 2003-2004, a computer entered our dressing room. An analyst was introduced who stored all the data. And initially we all felt, what is this computer going to teach us how to play? We don't need all that. You know, we've played for so long without any help, any assistance of this. Overnight to accept that change was difficult. And along the way, we realized that our team meetings were much smarter, cleverer. We were precise, and nothing was left to anyone's imagination, because at the press of a button, you could see everything on the screen, how the bowlers were going to bowl and what are the areas where our bowlers need to bowl to their batters. So it became very precise, and I thought that was a big, big change. Also, with the help of technology, something which I found really exciting was the hotspot, sneakometers, all the line decisions, which has made even a viewer's life exciting. I think viewers look forward to those things. Line decisions where whether the third umpire is going to give that run out or not. And literally by millimeters, the decisions are made. It's out or not out. And I've experienced that also in Wimbledon. And when it comes to line decisions, you know, yours truly was the first victim way back in 1992. Jonty Rhodes got me out in a test match in Durban.
Well, the only thing is they hear you, what you say when you swear. You know, the camera, the mic catches it. But anyway, I mean, you mentioned because you are from the old world and, you know, we are the ones who transitioned from those days and now to this high-tech days. So sometimes you feel left behind. You know, there's a phobia that, oh, I'm going to be left behind. I know less than my kids. But mobile phones, do you think they have made a lot of change in a person's life, how people consume this gadget now? Because it was just for calling, not anymore.
Well, also the days when mobiles were not there and we were touring for a number of days. And then to be in touch with our family was a tough task because, you know, they were also busy with their own things. And then to coordinate, you know, the previous phone call we had to actually decide that let's speak tomorrow at 9:30 p.m. You know, and then we had to make sure that we were available for that phone call. Otherwise, you know, coordinating was really, really difficult. But the mobiles were introduced and we thought, wow, this is brilliant. And suddenly, the connectivity improved, the correspondence got better. You know, we were traveling and we could still be in touch with our family. I think that is the most important thing, family and friends. And the next step was when the smartphones were introduced. Smartphones are literally controlling our lives. You know, your meetings, you know, your right from your alarms and reminders and all sorts of things. And then as the time goes by, things are getting more and more and more it's convenient for all of us. And with all these advanced technologies, God knows what's in store for us. And this has only made us get closer to our friends and to family members, which means a lot to me. And I've thoroughly enjoyed this. And it's all about convenience.
Accessible to the wife all the time. That's a flip side of it.
I think accessible to everyone, because in today's world, I think we rely heavily on these gadgets, and they literally determine the outcome, you know, which way, you know, the result is going to go, whether you're having important meetings, and it just doesn't apply to cricketers. I think it applies to everyone sitting in this room, and that has changed our perception.
Yeah, knowing you, I know you just don't say yes to anything that comes across. Oxygen, the services, what are your thoughts on them, and what is your connect?
My management team normally looks at all these things and if there is a brand connect or not, which is really, really important. And to see that, there are a lot of other things which are involved, you know, reliability and trust and those kind of things. Then to be able to live up to people's expectations or not. All these things are studied by my management, and then they bring this to me. I got to know that, you know, in 2007, this was introduced, Oxygen Wallet. And they were the first ones to do that. So, you know, that got me excited. But something which means even more to me, and it's the most important thing, is the village that I adopted, Puttam Raju Kandriga in Nellore. When I spent time there, I realized that, like all of us staying in big cities, we all aspire to be something. We all have dreams to become something. You know, we need to have something so that we reason to wake up in the morning and chase that dream. And so do they. A lot of youngsters over there aspire to be doctors, lawyers, engineers, sportsmen, all those kind of things. And for that, it cannot happen if they stay in that village. They have to move out to bigger places. And from there, if you have this platform where, you know, just at the press of the button, money is transferred instantly to your family members back home in the village. I think this digital platform, when it's used by the entire nation, not just the big places, that gives me a lot of satisfaction. And I think it's an amazing thing which Pramod and his team, they've been able to put through. And also with Mark's support. Mark, I know South Africa is coming here, so let me be nice to you right now. You know, when South African team comes here, I'll be sitting on the other side of the fence. But those are the things which mean a lot to me, and I'd like to congratulate Oxygen for that.
Well, I tell you what, I'm sure in about 160, 70 countries, nobody will let you ever pay for anything. But have you got a mobile wallet? Have you ever used a mobile wallet?
Well, I've experienced it, and I was fascinated by what you can do on the phone. And if you can immediately send money to your family members, your friends who've forgotten their wallet or whatever, they know that, you know, it's just a button away, basically.
Well, you've thrown us a googly because you were supposed to say no, and Pramod was supposed to tell you that.
No, Pramod, I've experienced that, but I'd like to know more about it. Please do tell me.
Well, you know, Sachin, I know you don't have to ever pay to have the occasion to take out money from your pocket, and I know you still carry the wallet. I think I want to show you something different. Let us exchange wallets, you know. Let me take your wallet, and I'll give you another one, which will help you. Where's the wallet?
Yeah. Do I keep the money or give you the money inside?
I'll hold it.
I need it. I need to exchange this wallet. I know there's lots of money in it. At least it's worth a lot more. And here is your wallet. It'll help you. It'll give you the experience of transferring money at the speed at which the little cherry raced to the boundary when you batted a Sachin on the ground. So this is the speed at which the money will be transferred in this wallet. Ladies and gentlemen.
Well, you can keep it in the pocket and Empire gives you, or just give him mobile wallet.
I don't know whether Sachin had an occasion to transfer, exchange his wallet with somebody. Here it is. It goes into my pocket.
See, when South Africa first toured India in 1991, that was an incredible experience to play against South Africa, because to see their faces, you know, they were completely shocked to see 100,000 people at Eden Gardens. And the response couldn't have been better. I was extremely happy, and I thought, you know, we are going to South Africa after that, which we did in 92 end, we went to South Africa, and incredible reception. You know, we landed in Durban, and we were taken in these convertible fancy cars all the way to the hotel, which was about literally 20 kilometers away. And on both sides of the road, there were people greeting us. So that was my first experience of South Africa. And when you talk about South African matches, how can I forget Hero Cup semifinals? You know, the most incredible match that I've been part of. Till the last ball, nobody knew what was happening. And, you know, constantly the momentum kept shifting. So that was one massive experience for me. South Africa, when you tour, you know, every time you go there, you see you are introduced to something new, which you are fascinated with. And there are a number of challenges when it comes to cricket. The conditions, the pitches, you know, the ball, the way it travels. And more so, when you play on high altitudes like Johannesburg. Yeah, Wanderers and Centurion, both these grounds, where something which you don't experience in the world, less oxygen. And when there is less oxygen, it's challenging. You know, it affects your game.
That's why we give them oxygen now.
But Sachin, coming back to the series briefly, you know, I'm not going to put you on the spot, but you moved on, your legacy is still intact. You think you've left the team in safe hands, Virat Kohli, Rehane and company?
I think our team is a fantastic team, extremely talented guys and committed guys. I know a lot of things are said about the players, but I know them closely. And when it comes to cricket, there are no shortcuts there. I know that the guys are committed, and it's a fantastic team. I'm going to step further and say that this series is going to be exciting series, be it T20, one day. For me, obviously, I think a test series is something that I'm looking forward to. A great team balance, both sides of the fence. And South African team also is. I've never played against a South African team which was, you know, okay side. They were always a very, very strong side. And it's no different right now.
I think AB de Villiers is, for me, is one of the most brilliant players in the world. But
Hashim Amla,
you know. And it's just such a wonderful array of
talk
from
about, don't forget Dale Steyn, Monnie Mockle.
Over the top.
He can bowl a googly, huh?
I mean, you talk about googlies. I think Imran Tahir is one good bowler. We'll have to play against him properly, and he possibly might be one of the leading bowlers here.
Well, that's coming from the man himself. He must be jumping through hoops right now, Imran Tahir. But let's move on back to why we're here today. And I would like to invite Ankur Saxena, who's the CEO of Oxygen Wallet, to tell us more about it.
Thank you, Atul.
And he'll give you a better demo of how to put in the money.
Sure. Thank you, Sachin, for having us. First, I'd like to show you how our instant money transfer matches your speed. So just give me a second and I'll quickly set it up to send money. Okay, there you go. Yep, it should be right there.
9,750, not bad.
That's all I had in my wallet, sir.
That's fast.
Yeah, it's your first experience with the Oxygen Wallet.
That's almost as fast as Monnie Mockle and Dale Steyn.
Almost.
I thought it's as fast as the cherry that went race to the boundary when you hit it all the time, Sachin.
Make sure you keep on doing that every day in the morning, right, Ankur? Yeah. Just keep on sending. Let it come.
So basically, what you can do with this is you can send money to your friends, send to someone's bank account, or pay your bills and top up your mobile. Not that I think you need to do that, but do various things. You can even gift money to people and you know, pay for services and different merchants. So hope you enjoy that, and we look forward to your experience and seeing how that goes.
Thank you,
so much.
Thank you.
I think that was a brief you know, picture of what it can do, but eventually people get down to it, they will find ways to maximize the benefits of it. And Sachin, we'd like to for you to sign these signages for you, and so that's the thing we want. Can we have a pen? Some music, please. And where did this thought of Sachin came, and what was the connect? Basically, people, when they spend money, they want just a picture with him. But I'm sure it's more than that.
Well, it's way beyond that. You know, Sachin has for almost quarter of a century exemplified what you would look for in the best product anywhere. You know, the passion that he has displayed, the discipline, you know, the dedication, determination, and excellence. You know, I don't think there is anything that you can be packaged so well. And then the man, as we all know, is so humble, so charming, and still keeps the boyish charm on his face. I think a product that I dreamt of, and we continue to want to build this product for the benefit of everyone, for the country as a whole, I think there could be no better person than him, who can connect to the masses, who can connect to anyone in this cricketing nation that we are. I think he is the one who has regaled and been a joy of billion hearts. And we too wish that his association will give us the opportunity to do the same and be a service that can be the joy of billions of people of this country.
Well done, Prabhu. I think you've said it, and nobody could have said it better. You said it all. And Sachin actually reflects all those qualities and more. And I'm just glad that this association happened, and I'm sure it'll go a long distance. So now I think we'll move on to for this Ganesh Chaturthi, so you have to gift him something. Thank you, Sachin. I will just about let you go, but before that, just a message from you. I know that there's a buzzword going, and you know you've got many lives while playing cricket. But now, you know, this is playing life easy with mobile wallet.
Now playing the life, it's easy with oxygen. That's our tagline. So remember that. Don't forget.
Yeah, I give you the hints. Anyway, so we'll let you go. Thanks a lot. It was wonderful to have you here on stage.
Thank you. Thank you.
And the meter is ticking. We can't afford you any longer.
Sachin!
Please don't go away. I'll invite Sunil Kulkarni, the Deputy MD, on stage. Thanks for all the patience. And I think there'll be some kind of parody people who are interested.